well, the build-up to replays is always different, that much we know. But the setting is absolutely spectacular on a beautiful, beautiful evening here in Dublin. Hope it's as nice wherever you are. Everybody now just waiting to get it underway. David Clifford hoping that this will be his day. There's been more than enough speculation, now it's time to resolve the issue. And I think goalkeeper Shane Ryan will feel a little more confident in himself now that he's got a first All-Ireland final under his belt. Likewise, Brian Howard. And Kevin, when we think back to nearly 2 weeks ago now, we think at the start of the match here, when Johnny Cooper had the task of picking up Clifford. I wonder what's going to happen today with the two of them.
Well, my guess is he will have the same task. He was their best man marker 2 weeks ago in the minutes leading up to that final. He remains, in my opinion, their best man marker. And Clifford is the big danger. So I have every sense that that will be the matchup again. We look at it very carefully. There's matchups all over the field for this particular evening.
And what about Jack McCaffrey? Who's going to pick him up?
Well, I still sense that he needs a touch-type man marker. I believe Paul Murphy is perfect for that, but it's likely to be someone like Breen O'Dioghlaí, perhaps. I don't think Stephen O'Brien, but we'll have to just wait and see.
Well, for both teams, it's about maximising opportunity now and realising the objective to win the most famed trophy in Irish sport, the Sam Maguire Cup. Won by Dublin on 28 occasions and by Kerry 37 times. The setting is perfect. It's Dublin who won the toss. Looks like they'll be playing from left to right in the first half. But before all of that, everybody just pausing now, standing for the playing of our national anthem, Our All the Via. His third All-Ireland final, and he has Maurice Deegan and David Coldrick running the lines this afternoon. Well, it's Dublin who won the toss, but in fact they're going to play from right to left in the first half, down towards Hill 16. Another big day for Jim Gavin. He is calmness personified. Could be on an afternoon just there reading his book.
Well, straight away, Ger, I can see James McCarthy has pitched up at midfield with Brian Fenton, so that much we know. He's definitely gone to midfield, as we expected, of course. And up front, it's very much as you are. Dublin have taken up the position. Kerry just trotting into them now.
So all set to go. The beginning of the 132nd All-Ireland Football Final and the 14th replay. Referee Conor Lane, who was in charge in 2016. Dublin Mayo replay. And the 2018 Dublin-Tyrone match in charge again, and the match gets underway. And straight away, there's a punch down that time by Brian Fenton to try and get Dublin on their way and get the first possession. Niall Scully firing it down here as far as Conn O'Callaghan, turning back inside now. Onto his left, looking for the opening score and getting it after about 17 seconds. What a start.
Beautiful work. You'll see on the replay, lovely little stutter step. That's loses the defender, and now the left foot over the bar. Brilliant start.
Well, he got a goal down there, of course, in the All-Ireland final 2 years ago after about 2 minutes. Well, here's Breon O'Dioghlaí now trying to mount Kerry's first attack. Getting it out as far as Adrian Spillane. Back it comes once again to Sean O'Shea, Ken Mayer player. First touch for Dermot O'Connor, probing ball in there. Ooh, went in all the way to Paul Gainey, came down awkwardly, surrounded by Dublin players immediately. Merchant getting the ball, did he touch it on the ground? He got it away anyway, got it out as far as Brian Howard. Picked up here by James McCarthy, wearing six but operating in the centre of the field. I think it's a role he will enjoy really well. Once again, it is Merchant. Started last year's All-Ireland final in the full back line, gives it out to Kieran Kilkenny, looking to make the perfect start. How about that? Two attacks, two scores. Dublin happy.
Brilliant driving from Merchant. Nobody could stay with him, nobody could pick him up. And a lovely lobbed hand pass then to Kieran Kilkenny onto his left foot as well. They're so clever with both feet. Over the bar. Great start, 2-0.
Shane Ryan kicking this one out, looking to try and retain it. They managed to hold on this time. Sean O'Shea. Kerry won 74% of their kickouts last time. Stephen O'Brien taking it forward. Merchant's after him. Paul Gainey having to go back, collect, take on David Byrne. Flicking it back in. Should have been intercepted. It's a drag back and it's going to be a free in. An opportunity for Kerry to get their opening score of the match. First opportunity then for Sean O'Shea. And it's a relatively straightforward run for him, just outside the 20-metre line. It was John Small who was doing the holding that time.
And right in the vicinity of Conor Lane, it was an easy call for him. And we know how good this fella is. He put on a clinic in the drawn All-Ireland, Sean O'Shea.
This to get Kerry on the scoreboard. So 2-1, early stages. Sean O'Shea, I suppose, will be the one that Kerry will be really hoping has a field day once again from the kick-out this time. There's a lot of movement around, and Dublin managed to measure it perfectly out to Johnny Cooper. Down as far as James McCarthy, kicking it in quickly and early. Collected in a strike here by Niall Scully. Checking, being marked by Brian O'Begley. Back out it comes to Paul Mannion. Mannion looking to get off to a very, very good start. Three attacks by Dublin, 3 points by three different players, all of them from play.
All of them with the left foot as well.
Well, that is a dream start. Tom O'Sullivan now. Conditions absolutely ideal, there's little or no breeze around in Croke Park today. Kerry have just got to work themselves into the game. Dublin, who were indicted in the minds of many people because they were slow starters in recent times, and they're off to a flyer here. That's O'Shea here, there looked to be a push. Referee has blown the whistle, I think. Ooh. Then there was a coming together with John Small there. Referee calling for calmness.
Well, nothing to see here, I'm sure. Just playing along.
Having a quick word with David Coldrick. With James McCarthy.
He joined it, didn't he, Jerry? He came in. I won't call it a lead. There's only two of them involved. He did join the fun. But I think that's it. Just calm it down and get going again.
Just an indication of the tension that is about. Inevitably so. David Moran to boot it in. Huge one inside towards Gainey again. Gainey beaten for it this time by Stephen Claxton. And his 106th match for Dublin in the championship. Brian Fenton. Judged by many people to be off colour in the drawn game, looking to get back to his very best. Back as far as Michael Fitzsimons, down here as far as Johnny Cooper. He's gone forward, Cooper, trying to get at the receiving end of this pass by Kieran Kilkenny, which reaches Dean Rock. Back as far as Kilkenny again, down here beautifully as far as Conor Callaghan. Callaghan, who has already scored in this match, back to Kilkenny, and Kilkenny's got his second, and Dublin are really motoring. They are very decisive, very determined, and very accurate. A right-footed point this time.
And no doubt, his attack, Jerk, is purring. The movement, the timing of the pass, and then the plenty of space, they're all executing so beautifully at the moment.
Shane Ryan playing it out towards the sideline this time, the wings, and Johnny Cooper pushes Dermot O'Connor. Free kick to Kerry. Kerry just delaying. It's Adrian Spillane who takes it. interesting to see where he plays in relation to David Moore and Jack Barry, but also David O'Connor, all midfield players, really. Booted in now. Again, it's in towards Skaney. Skaney being marked by David Byrne. Bounces back down, picked up here by Jack McCaffrey. Gets it away and taken under control smartly by Niles Scully. Beautifully out as far as Conor Callaghan. Causing problems for Clyde Morley early on. Retained here by Brian Fenton. Shows good awareness of what's on. Everybody marked inside. So Paul Mannion carries. Passes inside now. Conor Callaghan taking it past the last player there. Two or three would-be challenges. Back once again to Mannion. Looks so composed on the ball. Brian Fenton just calmly knocking this ball around now. Frustrating Kerry, freeing up Johnny Cooper. Stephen O'Brien, the nearest man to him. Back out to man of the match last time. Jack McCaffrey with a goal and three in that match. Now Scully again, no rush, no hurry. And wait until the ball is in the optimum position to make sure. Brian Fenton running it. Back here again to Mannion on the left. Up into the air, between the uprights and over the bar. He's got a second. That was some point by Dublin. Real calmness, real assurance, and a four-point lead.
Well, it's just the build-up, the patience, and then finally the way Fenton draws two markers and just dumps it back very quickly to Mannion. Accuracy, magnificent.
Great kick out that time by Shane Ryan, collected by Edwards Ballard. And then in came McCaffrey. He's saying he got the ball.
No, don't think so. I think he's very much on the looking side to pick up that call.
David Moran, ready to take this free kick. Down again it goes, this time towards Sean O'Shea, who moved into full forward, at least momentarily. Conor Callaghan was back helping. James McCarthy. It's a real business-like performance by Dublin so far, showing lots of urgency and a real hunger today to succeed. Maybe a hunger that was missing in large part the last time. Tom O'Sullivan taking it back from Jack Barry. Worked forward here through Tyke Morley. Ooh, just over the head of Paul Gailey, snappy by Kerry. You can't gift Dublin possession. The mood they're in right now. Brian Fenton, retained here by Kieran Kilkenny. Wouldn't have scored the last day. Scored 2 points already in this match. Conor Callaghan, in as far as Dean Rock. Given off here, that's under hit by O'Callaghan. Easy one for Shane Ryan. Paul Murphy taking that up initially. He's the captain of the field today because Gavin White hasn't been picked to start. Tyke Morley chasing over there to try and close down his options. Paul Mannion. Here's Paul Gailey. Forward once again, it comes to Morley. His team 4 points down after just 9 minutes. Into the corner here, intended for Stephen O'Brien. And that ball looked to have gone out. It has. Nothing quite going right for Kerry so far. Had a miserable opening 9 minutes.
Yeah, a lot of high ball in obviously has been the main feature of the opening few minutes, the opening 10 minutes, maybe five of them, and just missing the breaks by, you know, maybe a few inches each time, but it looks like it's something they're going to stick at.
Well, that early press by Kerry on the kick out by Dublin there wasn't shown, so it was an easy one for Dublin to take. And now to Bill John Small, getting it back as far as Mannion. He's covering a lot of ground already in the match. Cooper, quite happy, not marking David Clifford. Off there, setting up attacks, or trying to do so. Cut out by David Moran. Paul Murphy now, switching it across to Stephen O'Brien. Needs to have a big day. There's always a goal you feel in Stephen O'Brien. He's scored so many important goals in League and Championship for Kerry. Here's Brian Obiagli. Adrian Spillard. Dublin quite happy to just let them pass the ball around where they can't hurt Dublin.
And that's the issue. One merchant is sweeping and they have to slow it down. The high ball, it just doesn't have to have the extra man all the time in the full back line.
Merchant there just standing in front of the 20-metre line, as Kevin says. He's the free man back there. Paul Murphy across to Morley once again. It's the Dublin fans who are mostly in full voice right now after an excellent start. Jack Barry holding possession back as far as David Moran. Had 22 possessions in the drawn match. Brian O'Biagli. Kerry looking to try and make this attack really count for something. Biagli, and the hand went out, but the referee says play on. Gainey does. Now Scully. Carried down here once again towards Kieran Kilkenny. Owen Merchant is the player who is free. This is David Byrne. Been encouraged to carry it forward. Paul Mannion checking up against Jason Foley. Merchant once again. Here's Johnny Cooper. Once again, it is Owen Merchant playing today in his 11th ever championship match. Rebelling in the freedom. Lovely ball forward. Kilkenny checking back onto his left. Was he hauled back? No, the referee says play on. Certainly the Dublin fans up on Hill 16 thought there was a tug on the arm. Paul Murphy. Here's Gavin Crowley looking to exert more of an influence in the early stages of this match. Giving it in here to Jack Barry. Barry carrying it on. He's got Stephen O'Brien with him. Stephen O'Brien trying to go through the eye of the needle. Back it comes once again. And that's David Clifford under pressure, and he manages to put it over the bar. An opening point for David Clifford, and it's 5-3. And you can hear what the Dublin fans thought of that, because they thought there should have been a free up at the other end. Michael Fitzsimons bounces away here into Con O'Callaghan once again. O'Callaghan brushing aside the challenge of Thomas Sullivan. O'Callaghan knocks it over the bar. A second point by Con O'Callaghan. Dublin's attack flying at every opportunity, and they lead by 6-3. Well, this was some attack here. Once again, Dublin in full flight. That's where I thought that tall Paul Murphy clearly held back and fouled Kieran Kilkenny, but there was no free kick given. Of course, it was as a result of that that Kerry were able to go up the field and get a point. Six points to three. Gavin Crowley. David Moran now. All the way across as far as Dermot O'Connor. Three between them. Held on to by David Clifford. Looking to try and link up here once again with O'Connor. Connor, who played here in the league final back at the end of March. David Moran missed that match, but he's here, and the ball has just gone the wrong side of the post.
Yeah, we're setting it up now at 6-3. It's not the bad look it had as we just finish up in the first quarter. That kind of ugly look has gone off the scoreboard, and they're back in the game.
Here's Owen Merchant. Certainly having a very, very pleasant afternoon so far, largely without pressure. John Small. Much more pace, much more urgency in everything that Dublin do so far, and they've been clinical in front of goal. Kicked in by Niall Scully. Retained beautifully, chest high by Con O'Callaghan. Getting away from Paul Murphy. And the Kerry backs are in all kinds of difficulty. Even Johnny Cooper up there helping out. Niall Scully. Back to Kilkenny again. Over in that sunny spot over in front of the Cusick stand. Pat Tauss. Watch out. David Byrne kick. And David Byrne putting it over for only his second ever championship point. They're all getting in on the act. where last time they were under pressure at this stage of the game, today they are leading by 7 points to 3.
Now that's a tremendous tremendous point. The confidence to drive into the heart of the Kerry defence, knowing there's so many defenders there, backing himself, left foot, very accurate, over the bar.
What can Kerry do about this, Kevin?
Well, they have to get their defence sorted out, because every attack from Dublin looks like it's going to finish with a score.
Tom O'Sullivan giving it to Brian O'Biagli. Back here as far as Adrian Spillane. I'm sure Kerry fans are thinking in terms of when will they bring on his brother, Killian, player who got that goal in the last match in the second half. Paul Murphy. Jack Barry, hesitant initially, then giving it off. O'Biagli as far as Adrian Spillane, driving through the centre, about to be challenged, but the challenge is ineffective, and he gets that kick away brilliantly and puts it over. And now there are just 3 points between them.
Another fine attack, no doubt, and a really excellent score at the end of it. Spillane tearing again, a lovely skill, lovely balance, and the right foot over the bar.
Cluxton easily able to pick out Johnny Cooper. Measured pass back in here to bounce kindly in front of Scully. Had to take it away initially from Brian O'Biagli, and then came Paul Gainey. They forced it to overhold. Free kick, and the referee bringing the free kick up to the Dublin 65-metre line. David Moran in there, as far as David Clifford. A point scorer already, off his left, up and over the bar. And Kerry are beginning to eat into Dublin's lead. It's a two-point game.
Well, he gets so much space here. Goes to the quick free. Look at the curl on that jerk. Absolutely delightful. Back to two.
12 points so far, Kevin, and not one of them from a free kick.
That's tremendous stuff. I mean, they're going at this now. Hammer and tongs. Every opportunity been brought out to the very end. And accuracy tremendous so far.
Merchant able to carry it. Give it to Johnny Cooper. Two attacks, so potent, always so threatening. Brian Fenton, very much more involved than he was the last day. Central to the play from the middle of the park upwards. Paul Mannion. Popping up in so many different positions. Merchant again. Back here as far as David Byrne. Ooh, he's given that one short, and it's enabled Stephen O'Brien to nip in before Jack McCaffrey can get there. Two pacey players, and the referee allowing an advantage because there was, a tug back on O'Brien. Now he's going to get the free kick. It was McCaffrey who fouled him.
Well, there wasn't a sinner up in the Kerry half of the field. That was the major issue for poor Stephen O'Brien when he looked up. There wasn't anybody in, so you had to hold on to it.
And right now there's just one inside the 20-metre line, and that is Paul Gainey. O'Biagli holding. And maybe this is one of the reasons why there's a lack of pace in their attacks so far. And they've got pacey players, Kerry, but they're holding in midfield. Spillane back this time from Jason Foley. Carried forward by the on-field captain, Paul Murphy, an All-Ireland winner here with Kerry 5 years ago. Jack Barry. Taking everything that Dublin have been able to put at them so far in the opening 19 and a half minutes, and they've come back strongly themselves. Stephen O'Brien ready to take on Brian Howard. Going back past Howard, and the reinforcements arrive, but he got it away as far as Sean O'Shea, and then Clifford coming in and putting it over. Really good point by Kerry. Three players involved. There was maturity and there was calmness and pace about that. And a wonderful finish. And it's 7 points to 6. And it's another thriller at Croke Park.
He's a ball player, this fella is. With the right foot this time. Saw the dummy on the inside. Lovely patient play again. It's just the level of action of both teams is just... It's unbelievable at this elite level of the game. The All-Ireland final, no nerves at all. Another top players, but the accuracy shown, I haven't seen this for a long time, Jerry.
Well, these are the top two teams around. Dublin going for their 5 in a row. Kerry just trying to win one All-Ireland here. McCaffrey, such pace, dispossessed there, but it breaks kindly for Kieran Kilkenny. Darts forward again here. Gavin Crowley goes goal side of him. Waiting for an obvious pass. There was none coming, so he confidently kicked it himself, and he's kicked a third. Kieran Kilkenny, in his 42nd championship match, has made it 8-6.
more of it, isn't it? Because he's if you offer him up the left, he'll take that. Cuts back in on his right, he's equally comfortable. And again, over the bar.
This short kick out as far as Jack Barry works in Kerry's favour. Morley then as far as Brian O'Biagli. Barry taking it back. Likes to knock it forward with the hand, but use the left boot mostly. Jack Barry in full stride. Coming after him here is Paul Mannion. Released back as far as Paul Gainey, and Gainey cracks one over, his second, it's another for Kerry. They're going attack after attack, and now it's 8-7 with 21 minutes gone.
Well, we did know coming into it that they're two top attacking sextets, if you like, and they're really showing us, both defences under tremendous pressure.
And struggling. But Simon's here, as far as Kieran Kilkenny, opting to boot it all the way back as far as David Byrne, the Nev Olaf man. Who didn't start the replay 3 years ago. He was dropped for that, but he came on pretty early when there was a black card for Johnny Cooper that day. Brian Fenton. No way through initially, but he's confidently holding on to it. Jack Barry. Got to stay with him. Cooper now. In, as far as Mannion. Looking to put one into the corner here, but there was far too many Kerry backs there. So back to McCaffrey to try and use his pace now to go by. Adrian Spillard, but then a couple of challenges ready to confront him. So uses Cooper instead. Kilkenny. He's made a terrific start to the game. Brushing off the challenge there of Brian O'Biagli. Dean Rock. Booted back to Michael Fitzsimons.
Paul Murphy sweeping all the time. That's why Dublin just can't get a look into the full line.
Brian Howard sees that, moves forward, a couple of Kerry players just in front of him. Cooper again. Well, he's having a much more comfortable afternoon here. Both teams putting the accent on attack. It's making for a very entertaining game. Some of the Kerry fans now, I think, are feeling that Dublin should be making more of an attempt to attack. But that, of course, is nonsense. It's up to them to win the game in any fashion they want to do so. They've got 8 very good points so far. Kieran Kilkenny into the corner here as far as Conor Callaghan. Waiting, then darting forward, real good pace up to the 20 metre line and beyond. Oh, he's put it over the bar. He might have put it into the top left hand corner of the net, but he's got his third point. And another one for Dublin.
There's a bit of a question of whether the advantage is going to be called back. But Conor Lee, I know he's going to award that in the book out and put it into the book. And good advantage again. Exactly as you called it, Chair.
Sensible. 9-7. Dublin ahead. Jim Gower there with a word or two to David Coldrick. You might remember in the draw match there was an advantage also involving Conor Callaghan and Shane Ryan.
Just got up on the scoreboard, that's what the limited disquiet was around the stadium.
On that occasion, the referee that day gave Conor Callaghan an advantage of Shane Ryan, stopped him with the side of his body, otherwise the goal would have counted. Here comes Sean O'Shea, 1 point so far, that was from the free. Paul Gagging, checking back inside here, taking on Byrne, holding off the challenge, another Dublin player trying to come in to help. That was Michael Fitzsimons. That's Stephen O'Brien, and he was being held back that time. Somewhat, or rather, doing the holding. It was a desperate challenge on O'Brien's part, and ends up being a free to Dublin.
The pass across from Paul Gainey was a little bit out of control, and Stephen O'Brien started behind his man, and he's fouling in the attempt to get in front. Good call again by the ref. He's really on the spot all the time, wherever the action is. Man in black isn't too far away, and that gives him a great opportunity to make the right call.
A wonderful first 25 minutes of this match, well handled by Conor Lane. Free to Dublin then. Peter Keane will be happy enough with the way in which his team has recovered from a really bad start, where they were 4 points behind in the early stages.
We just talk this lateral build-up that we saw on the last play, which, you know, takes a lot of time and takes the energy out of the game. You wouldn't want to see too many of that, but as you rightly say, they can win it any way they want. It's up to Kerry to come out and get the ball off Dublin.
Niall Scully across here as far as Brian Howard. keeper who exerted a big, big influence in the first match. Chipped out here to Mannion once again. Would have been glad of the second opportunity here to play against Kerry. A very bountiful summer with 22 points going into the last game. 2 points today, 2 points in the draw match. Conor O'Callaghan. Again, it's Stephen O'Brien making that very, very awkward for him. Back once again to Brian Howard. So they haven't made an awful lot of headway, and Kerry have all the bodies back into key positions. Or is that the case? John Small. Now it's James McCarthy. Jack McCaffrey. A little darting run. Now he takes off and then runs into bodies. The body that time of O'Bjogli and Sean O'Shea, the one who blocked him out. Gets as far as David Clifford. Clifford leaves two Dublin players in his wake. And there's a run forward here. And it's by the fullback, Tadhg Morley. Morley right up to the 20-meter line. Was he fouled just outside?
He was. There's that professional foul that we hate. And now we have to think about black cards. Is it deliberate? Well, of course it is. But is it in the black card country? Probably not.
Well, that's where Sean O'Shea intervened. That's where Brian O'Bjogli got it forward. And that's Tadhg Morley coming in. And that's where he came a proper and was stopped.
Yeah, he's in having a discussion now, because this is the issue with this rule. Is it deliberate? Has he deliberately pulled him to the ground? He knows what he's doing. Of course, we all know that. It's the professional foul, essentially. Morley did great. Albert Clifford did great, too. What a pass inside. And it's a big call now for Conor Lane.
Conor Lane has to interpret. It's Michael Fitzsimons in his 10th championship season. I think it's going to be a yellow card for rough play. Across Fitzsimons to have a word with the umpire. Probably better off, we just let the referee get on with his business and make the call. It's a black card.
No, I think he meant yellow. I think he did. He?
Just a noting, we believe, even though he flashed a black card. A noting only, I'm told. Well, that is a bit of a let-off.
He certainly did flash it. I think that was an error by him. He just the excitement of the moment.
Well, there's plenty of excitement about, so it's going to be a free in. 9-7, Sean O'Shea looking to kick his second point. And he've got 10 points in the draw match. Nicely over, no trouble for him.
But sure, we so badly need something around this professional foul. Soccer, because that's a huge goal opportunity there. Just taking it.
We'll see what will happen in the close season when all of these things will be debated and discussed. Free kick to Dublin anyway. David Clifford, the one who committed the offence there. So Dublin have the chance now to carry it downfield. Brian Fenton. Huge, booming ball down, fabulous catch by Conor Callaghan, takes off past Tom O'Sullivan, gives it back to Dean Rock, and Rock gets among the scorers as well. Got 10 the last day, 3 of those were from open play, and his first one here, again, very, very calm, sensible play by Dublin.
Coming on the loop, really nice play, and what a reply, what a great reply.
Big leap in the air, 2-1, but it comes in favour of Kerry. And Jack Barry goes off. Brian Howard chasing after him, trying to catch up. Barry then checking his stride, ready to give it back to a support player. That's Paul Murphy. And now it's David Clifford fancying this one. But he put it to the right, and it's Kerry's third wide. Dublin without a wide so far after a half an hour and 10 points on the board. Some performance.
Yeah, 3 wides from Kerry, and that's one. You know, David Clifford, I fancy him to get them from that distance. He has that ability. Wasn't wide by too much.
Has that confidence as well, hasn't he?
Yeah, for sure. He's having a terrific game.
What a great catch that was. Good mark by Brian Fenton. All the way down as far as Paul Mannion. Taking on Morley. Going inside. He's already got 2. Still at 2. Counter-offensive immediately from the goalkeeper out to his quarterback, Jason Foley. As far as Kevin O'Connor, got the nod to start in place of the named captain on the programme, Gavin White. Through to Kerry. And Gavin Crowley giving it to Foley to take. 4 minutes to go to half-time. Very, very entertaining opening half.
It's great stuff.
Paul Murphy.
It's just great stuff. Great stuff.
Tom Sullivan now. 2 points between them. Can Kerry narrow it down to one with this next attack? O'Sullivan. Jack Barry. Holding things up. David Moran. Ready to drive forward. He's got an advantage. And he's got a free kick now. And this will bring Sean O'Shea back out to kick this one, I imagine.
Big man drives at you, there is very little you can do, and that's a holding offence, and will he take it out of the hands or the ground? That's the only question we need to ask.
Well, he's very, very confident, I think, hitting it either way. It's his 12th time playing championship, by the way, Sean O'Shea, in Croke Park, won all of his 5 matches as a minor. Jack McCaffrey is the player who is down injured at the moment. Such a thrillless match the last day. And I can remember him going off in an All-Ireland final a couple of years ago, didn't finish it, with a bad injury on that occasion.
These are not good pictures from Dublin perspective.
Well, it's all very well having the subs on the bench who can come on and can do a job, that's for sure. Incidentally, Keane O'Sullivan did not start, and there was speculation he might, especially when they named him among the subs. Jack looks to be in difficulty here, as you can see. Man knows all about injuries. He is a doctor by profession.
I think he's okay. That's good. That's good.
Wants to continue. And the play will continue now with this free kick, which Sean O'Shea is going to take. So far a goal and 50 in his championship career. Measuring it nicely and putting it over the bar. Rarely misses one. Flawless performance in the drawn match. And it's a one-point game. Dublin have always led in the match so far. And you may recall in the drawn match, Kerry only led in the game, I think, for about 10 minutes in all. Owen Merchant. Relapsed by Fitzsimons, now ready to take off, unchallenged. The nearest man in front of him is David Clifford, and a couple of more Kerry players now approaching. Kieran Kilkenny does an immense amount of good work, constantly running. Niall Scully. The word we are getting is that there will be 3 minutes of additional time at the end of the first 35. Scully. Back to John Small. Jack Barry trying to keep tabs on him. Small reaching a dead end, giving it back to Mannion with that left boot, and again he leaves it short. That's the second time he's done that. David Moran, back out now. Plenty of space in front of him. Dean Rock trying to catch up with him. It's still David Moran. Nice turn of pace by Moran. Now he gives it off as far as David Clifford. Missed the last one. Plays this ball inside for O'Brien. Stephen O'Brien came in. Challenge came in, and the referee's press says perfectly fair.
And it was.
Free kick.
Yeah, Mick Fitzsimon, brilliant. Just on the first touch, bang, hits him and the ball flies out of his hand. Great tackle.
Some great play overall. Kieran Kilkenny into James McCarthy. McCarthy flying forward here. On his left shoulder here was David Byrne. He scored already in this match. And passed it inside this time. It was intended for O'Callaghan. And the crowd behind the goal feeling he was fouled. Play continues. No free given. Paul Murphy playing it away out as far as Primo Bianchi. Certainly the Dublin fans feel there are a couple of calls that didn't go their way down there in the opening half. Thomas Sullivan darting forward here. Mannion tries to get goal side of him. Brad Fenty gets in with the challenge as well. But it's over vigorous this time. And not fair.
I tell you, that last one, Gerard, there was a lot of Johnny Cooper 2 weeks ago about it. Not looking at the ball, the flight of the ball.
We'll get a chance to see it again, I'm sure. That was well done. Conor Callaghan back, helping out.
Mr. Kenny to got the point and touch, though. He broke it. Huge bravery on the breaking ball. We're seeing a lot of that from both teams. Hugely committed. This half has flown by.
Well, it's been wonderfully expressive football by two most talented teams. Jack McCaffrey looking to keep their unbeaten run going. Kerry, rated by many people, the one team who might lower their colours, whether it's today or some other day, just don't know. Johnny Cooper back out as far as Kieran Kilkenny. And that ball's given away badly to Paul Murphy. Murphy with Kerry racing forward and a point behind. Looking to try and level up the match now with about 90 seconds to go in the opening half. There's a man loose on the right-hand side as Paul Gainey carries it forward. He had an option, doesn't need the option. He kicks it up and over the bar. A third point of the match for Paul Gainey. Brilliantly done. Totally committed and totally confident in his belief that he would score in a marvellous run.
And he looked up. Well, there's the one. It's a little bit early. Oh, there's the Fitzsimons challenge. Nothing but excellence written all over it. Just to go back to that last one. Options both sides, but bangs it over the bar. Jack McCaffrey's in trouble, perhaps.
Well, that's the second time that the trainers have been in. This is what happened here a moment ago. That is Tom O'Sullivan against Conn O'Callaghan. Did you see enough there?
Well, it's very similar to 2 weeks ago. If you remember the Johnny Cooper on David Clifford. Eyes not on the ball. Certainly an entanglement and could easily have pointed the penalty spot.
Kerry got away with it. Rough play spotted by the referee, by Brian O'Biagli on Jack McCaffrey. And there could be the opening card of the match here. That's the first yellow card of the game. It's been played in a great spirit. It's been brilliant football. Up and down the field, nothing negative about it. The best attackers in the game doing what they do so well and entertaining everybody here and hopefully all around the country as well. Owen Merchant, last few seconds of the first half. Teams level for just the first time. David Byrne. Oof. The challenge this time comes in from Stephen O'Brien, and there is no doubt in the referee's mind, and he's reaching for his notebook. I think he's noting the offence.
Dublin players getting a little bit frustrated. I feel a lot of the calls in that half perhaps did not go with them, and you could give them a big part in that debate. They're just coming off second best in a lot of these marginal calls. They do tend to even themselves up as the game goes on.
Fenton knocking it in here towards Conn O'Callaghan, two against him. Breaks away to the goalkeeper, to Shane Ryan, and the referee blows his whistle and ends a wonderful opening 35, 38 minutes. Conn O'Callaghan will probably feel that he might have got a penalty there late on. Remember that Dublin led by 4 points in the early stages in the opening 10 minutes of this game. But credit Kerry for coming back. Credit Dublin for some brilliant scores as well. It's been a wonderful opening half to the replayed All-Ireland Football Final. And here at the break, it's honours even. It's Dublin 10 points, Kerry 10 points. We're back in just a moment. David Connolly on for his 52nd ever championship match. This decade of the Dubs, it's their ninth final match in since 2011. He's been involved in quite a few. They've ultimately won six, drawing two, and winning four of their six by a solitary point. Both sides would settle for a solitary point win here. It's Owen Merchant bursting forward immediately. Moreland trying to catch up with him. Merchant still going. What a goal! What a goal! His first ever time to score anything in the championship. The second half surge, it seems, has begun.
Well, a big error on the throw-in does David Moore, and it's his ball to catch. Nobody on him, and for some reason he breaks it straight into the strike pattern of Merchant, and all the way right to the penalty spot. Bang! What a start!
It was like watching some young lad about under 14 who was racing through that time against a man who's been around for quite a while in David Moreland. 110 to 10 points. Here's Gavin Crowley. Dispossessed. Robbed there by Brian Howard. Another brilliant start to the half here by Dublin. Remember, they led in the first half twice by 4 points. And Kerry managed to reel them in. Maggie giving it here as far as Kilkenny. outstanding performers during the first 35 minutes. Likewise, Conor Callaghan and Brian Fenton, much more involved. Drilling it low in here as far as O'Callaghan turns. Tom O'Sullivan looking for more. He's got a point. Fourth point of the match for Conor Callaghan.
Who's power and pace, and it's so difficult to mark it. Drills it over the bar. Might have been caught up for steps. I thought in the build-up, but ref lets him off. But once he sees the goal, he ain't going to miss.
He's so strong, so forceful, so dangerous. So we've got a four-point difference immediately.
It's a big lead.
Played 2 minutes of the second half.
That's a big lead, Jordan, in the context of this game poised at half-time. So delicately, 2 minutes of the second half. That's a margin now.
You're thinking back to the semi-final against Mayo, and you're beginning to wonder, could Dublin do exactly the same to Kerry? Jack Barry moving forward. It's one against two down there, but Paul Gainey's gone out to reach for that one. Gives it back to Gavin Crowley. Gainey once again, stretching it out there. Bounces for David O'Connor to take on James McCarthy. Looking for Kerry's first score of the second half. And he's put it well wide. Fourth wide of the match for Kerry. This was that goal again, so early in the second half, right into the corner.
He's just easily passed that ball there. He just popped it to the side of the keeper. Keeper never budges. And a brilliant goal. What a goal.
David Clifford. Again, the space here. Clifford exploiting that space, taking on Byrne, throwing the shoulder into the 20-metre line and up and over. First and the second half by Kerry, and David Clifford the scorer. Goal between them.
Lovely show. Here's the goal again, Merchant. Look at that. Maybe if David Bourne had done the professional foul there, that might have been better for Kerry, but we'd have missed a cracker of a goal.
Brilliant piece of individual skill by Owen Merchant from the Lafayette club. Here he is again. Is it the ball down there? You can sense that. Taking it back from his clubmate, Johnny Cooper. Conor Callaghan has gone back on occasions to help out McCarthy. Over it comes as far as Niall Scully. Picked up here by John Small. Then Brian Howard. Back to the goal scorer once again. Having a little look inside, there's three against two in and around the, it's now three against, four against three. Inside in front of the Kerry goal. Dublin just holding.
Taking the pace out of the game, like a four up, they just want to settle things now. Don't give Kerry any quick opportunities to get back into it. A 3 point lead now, you know, ticking them nicely. That's where the bit of fat is.
Dublin know how. Brian Fenton. Beautifully in. Slipping but holding possession, Connolly, but it's Sean O'Shea who got his hand there to deflect it away before he was fouled. The referee with a good look out again. This time calling down the side. Who was he going to
call? Paul Mannion. It was Paul Mannion.
Just noting anyway. Possibly Connolly, yeah.
Yes, it is.
Jack Barry from O'Gael. Bursting forward here with Peter Townsend and the whole time, Brian Fenton. To Gainey again, 3 points in the first half. Very good contribution by Paul Gainey. Measures it beautifully, up and over. That's a great score by Paul Gainey. It was a difficult angle for him. He had it all to do himself and showed leadership here and manages to make it a 2 point game.
Particularly brilliant at that shot there. He comes out in on the narrow side and you think it's against the run of it for a right footer, but he's really, really good at it.
The Simons showing creativity, showing daring and going forward here. Back to Kilkenny. Sensible play by Dublin. Conor Callaghan setting it up for James McCarthy, raiding on that left-hand side, and then intervening is Jason Foley. Back to Tom O'Sullivan. Using Paul Murphy to get that ball away. Out to Paul Gainey once again. only two players in the other half of the field, so they've got to hold possession here, Kerry. And that was a push, was it a throw? But the referee seeing the player on the ground. Decent recovery by Kerry to the concession of the goal and the points so early in the second half. Gavin Crowley here. That was Brian Fenton coming in with the shoulder.
I'd be happy enough with that shoulder stuff. But this is there's what looks like the throw, but he's taking a fair belt. I think Kerry would count it as lucky that it all ends up with a sideline ball to him.
Stephen O'Brien still to score, but Owen Marchant, the man who was marking him, was the one who got forward so quickly, so decisively at the beginning of this half to crack it into the back of the Kerry net. Jim Gavin will be very, very pleased. It's a good choice. Played well when it came out for the last 20 minutes of the draw match. Showed supreme confidence and wonderful finish.
And it was from the throw in, it was a very easy catch for David Bourne. We all backed off from the left, and for some reason he decided to drain the ball, and Merchant was onto him like a bullet.
All of these set plays, and the throw-in is a set play, the kick-outs are set plays, they're also crucial in the modern game, and we're playing at this very elite level. Jason Foley, as far as Stephen O'Brien, taking it past Scully. Foley again, he's got a lot of pace, former school's athlete. Off it comes to Clifford, he's already scored in the second half. Back here to Gainey, back outside again to O'Sullivan this time, and that's just gone to the right. It's a missed opportunity. And you've got a goal in the Munster final for Peter Keane's team.
And a triangle of passes, and the two good shooters give it to the cornerback.
Dublin's kickouts have been really, really good. 69-17 so far, successful. This one to Mannion, and Mannion puts it the wrong side of the post. It's just the first wide of the game by Dublin, and it comes, as you can see, after 43 and a half minutes. It's been a wonderful forward showing, by and large, by both of these teams. Shane Ryan now just trying to sum up what's available to him. There's a line of four Dublin players right across the front, outside the 20-metre line.
Has to go long, surely.
Down towards David Morland, and there's a push in the back, and Kerry will get a free kick. A push by Brian Howard. Howard, he made that wonderful catch, you might remember, in the drawn game to set up the goal, which was put in the net by Jack McCaffrey. Jack Barry, back to Morland. Options to his right, decides to try and carry it forward here a little bit. See what might develop. Now it's Dublin's turn to get two lines of defenders back in front of Sean O'Shea. Hitting it crisply. Has he delivered the point? He most definitely has. The first to come from open play for him. Four today. And now it's just a one-point game in this amazing sequence of matches this year between Dublin and Kerry.
It's twice now that they've made big recoveries. First quarter and again after the goal. Each time, certainly the first 10 minutes, I would have said, you know, ball burst, game over. And yet they get their play back in and bring it back level. And here they are again, right back in it.
And challenging that kick out there, it was Barry who got to it. But it's Dublin who managed to get the ball back. And it's Dermot Connolly. Nice ball down, brilliant ball down to Kilkenny. Great delivery, and that will be a lovely point. Kilkenny makes it. First of the second half for him, his fourth in all. That was from Connolly's sublime ball in here, which was taken chest high by Kilkenny and rounded off in style. 112 to 13 points.
Well, what a ping. Oh, no, not another hamstring. And
Paul Murphy.
Yeah. And he's in bother now, but to go back to Connolly just for a second, what a ping. Distance, takes out the defence, straight gear in Kilkenny. Over the bar. That's what this guy can do. Magic.
Well, he is a magic footballer, David Connolly. That's some ball. Look at the way it was taken so calmly and so decisively to make it 112-13. Kerry are preparing to make a change. And I can tell you that Killian Spillane from Temple Know, who got their goal in the draw match, is ready to come in. Can he make the big difference again? Jim Gavin will appreciate that Kerry have got other players, key players, in particular Tommy Walsh, that they can yet bring in. We're only some 11 minutes into the second half. Murphy trying to walk it off. If it's a hamstring, it's hard to do.
Indeed, and that's what we fell to Jack McCaffrey as well, when he had to leave the game at half-time. They just are not at the kind of injury you can run off.
So once again, a two-point game. Murray gets forward, gets away with that. Retained by Sean O'Shea. Now Gavin Crowley, booting it down towards the 20-metre line. Brilliant catch by Gainey. That's superb. Laying it off here to Tom O'Sullivan. Back out to Brian O'Biagli. Retained here by Clifford. Clifford trying to edge inside. Gives it back. Spillane. That's Adrian Spillane. Gainey again after that wonderful, wonderful fetch. Jack Barry doesn't want to hit it with the right boot. Gives it off to David Moran instead. And Moran has missed after all the good work by Gainey.
That is magnificent. And what a game. What a game he's having. I've been down for 4 points as well from play. And he's really taken the game to Dublin. But again, so well poised and so much to look forward to on the last 20, 25 minutes.
But you do feel at this level, at this stage of the match, every chance has got to be taken. That's cut out here by Dermot O'Connor. Looking up, seeing where Sean O'Shea is in a race with John Small. Small didn't trip him. You'd be dangerous in doing that. With a black card, Sean O'Shea retains possession. Fitzsimons trying to hurry him into an error. He's not going to do that. Kicks it in, and eventually the ball is given away. And it's David Byrne who gets there. Out as far as Connolly. Out to Kieran Kilkenny. Moving away smartly. Brian Fenton, real figure of assurance in the middle of the park for Dublin, has been the man who has never been on a losing Dublin championship team.
Just to go back for a second to Sean O'Shea, very tired looking turnover with a lot of play on the ball. He really should have recycled and come back out. Very ambitious with his efforts.
That's one of the things about Kerry. If you look at them, the attack, they've got the 21-year-olds and 220-year-olds and Clifford and Dermot O'Connor. Big experience for all of them. David Byrne. Gavin White might be coming into the match eventually here. Could be for Paul Murphy if Murphy has that injury. Scotty. As far as Howard again. Connolly. Kilkenny. Yeah, just taking the heat out of the game here now. Frustrated Kerry. Holding on to their 2-point advantage and possession. And every time they go forward, they look so dangerous. Brian Howard. Scully, it comes again. Johnny Cooper now. Taking it back from Brian Fenton. No particular hurry with the hand at this stage. Just want to hold. The seconds tick away. Kerry can't get possession. And the time is their enemy as much as anything else. Kilkenny. Well, they've got to get in and they've got to make challenges. Here's Fenton once again. I think this is about the third time he's had the ball in his hands in this particular attack. Kilkenny once more. Looking for somebody maybe to come through the centre. Eventually that person is Merchant. To his right he's got Scully. Decides to bypass him. Full of confidence. Now wisely giving it back to David Byrne.
Yeah, the killer is, of course, after all this patient build-up, as if the team do get scores, it's like a real killer for the opposition.
Well, they've had the ball for at least 60 seconds now. Yeah. Brian Howard, while they've got the ball, Kerry cannot score at the other end. Owen Merchant. One of those 21-year-olds playing in today's replay final. Again, there's a degree of booing now because certainly the Kerry fans feel this isn't terribly sporting. Again, Dublin are playing to a particular method and purpose. Fenton eventually manages to get the ball back. And Paul Mannion completes the move with a point. They must have had possession for about 90 seconds. And finally, Mannion runs it off with his third point of the game. Fed that ball by Brian Fenton. And it's 1-13. To 13 points.
And that's the killer I was talking about. They have it for so long, and Mannion finishes it Stephen O'Brien had a great chance to steal the ball. I think it was off Brian Fenton when he came in on the blind side, but it was tidied up. A brilliant score by Dublin. The patience, the skill, the movement.
Adrian Spillane and Brian O'Byagley making way, and it'll be Gavin White and Jack Sherwood who will come in.
No Tommy Welch yet.
No, still being kept back. It's a gamble, but they will eventually bring him in. But this is Jack Sherwood, who's impressed. That's a great block down. Kilkenny got the hands down there. Perfect timing. James McCarthy wins it. Held in possession, free out to Dublin. It's a very good spell for the Dubs at this stage. Kerry with just 3 points at the second half so far. Dublin with a goal at three. David Byrne, one of the point scorers earlier on. Dermot Connolly. On his left, is it inside? Afraid it's outside this time. Just the second wide. This was that block again. How about this for a perfect block by Kieran Kilkenny?
And at the other end there, we just see the little bit of championship rustiness that Jeremy Connolly obviously will bring to it at this late stage. He hasn't seen that many minutes.
Gavin White, there's another Kerry player by the way down with what looks like a cramp as the play continues. Dermot O'Connor, that's Jason Foley. Just for a while, Kerry are down to 14 players, really. David Moran giving this to Jack Barry. Morley. Back it comes to Tom O'Sullivan. Well, they will rue some of their misses because there have been six rides in all by Kerry. Stephen O'Brien getting away from Scully. Still O'Brien is on an advantage. He's still going. He's still going. Stopped by Cluxton. The referee gave him the opportunity, and once again, it's Stephen Cluxton, the leading goalkeeping exponent in Gaelic football, who produces the stop, and Kilkenny takes it away for the defending champions. Well, it's as good as a score at the other end, you may be certain. Darting inside is Brian Howard. Three men are after him. Out it comes to Brian Fenton. Swiftly up here as far as Con O'Callaghan, 4 points against his name so far. Out to Dean Rock, who's just got one and who hasn't been called on to take the frees because Kerry haven't been conceding frees. Very disciplined defending. Merchant is in a bit of difficulty, I can tell you, off camera right now, and he's been helped off the field. I think it's a cramp. He's run himself into the ground. The applause you're hearing in the background is applause for the goal scorer Owen Merchant. Conor Callaghan, meanwhile.
Billy McMahon is getting ready to come in for him, and Tommy Walsh on the other side. I see him warming as well. Just, there's going to be two big substitutions shortly.
Especially with 90 minutes now gone in the second half, and this match to be determined. Who's going to win it? Well, Johnny Cooper put his fist up, and that's usually a signal for those inside.
We recognise that one, all right.
Interpret, if you will. Here's Cooper. Too many Kerry players there in front of him. Paul Mannion moving it out into space against stretching the Kerry backs. Look back there, helping out of Sean O'Shea. Mannion's made an angle, a perfect angle, and a perfect score from a wonderful player. This is more like, much more like the Paul Mannion that we did not see in the draw match.
He's got to play this over to Gainey on his right hand side. We don't see him in camera shot, but believe me, he's there. You've got to get that ball across the goal. You'll see it now afterwards. It is a great save. This is a huge moment in the final jerk. Here's Gainey on the right.
Tommy Walsh has come on. Billy McMahon has also come on, as you have noted, for Dublin. Dermot O'Connor, the one who made way. And here is Tommy Walsh. Still going forward. He's been given an advantage by the referee. Brian Fenton is arguing the toss with Conor Lane. The referee takes his notebook out, and it's got to be a free in at the end of all of that. We were watching Killian Spillane earlier on preparing to come in, and I just didn't see him. Did he come in?
Well, Gavin White definitely is in. I can see him right in front of me. I haven't seen Killian Spillane, it has to be said.
Certainly Tommy Walsh is down there anyway and causing a few moments of panic for the Dublin defenders. It's 11 minutes since Kerry last scored in this match. David Clifford with the free. and he tucks it up and over the bar. 5 points for David Clifford, another one for Kerry. So now it's 114 to 14 points. And Peter Keane will feel that his team are still very much in there with a real chance of winning. Again, perfect kick out by Stephen Cluxton as he goes short to Philly McMahon. Howard up into space here for Dean Rock to go racing after. After him goes Jason Foley. Good take by Rock. Controlled here by Kilkenny. Gibbard Conley had a quick little look up. Then trying to steal a march on Gavin White. White staying with him. Two players trying to dispute him. What a transfer! Brilliantly done to Scully. Scully blazes it over. Took a number of steps there, but he got in there.
What his point. We saw the pass from Conley, Jerry. Brilliant. Brilliant.
115 to 14 points. Jack Sherwood for Kerry. Back they come. David Moran down to Tommy Walsh, laying it off brilliantly as far as Clifford, shouldered by Philly McMahon. Clifford again, a lot of Dublin bodies between the Kerry player and the goal. In it comes, and out it comes to Gainey, and Gainey strikes it poorly this time and misses for once. He's had a very good match, but they can't afford shooting errors at this stage. Coming into the game here is number 20, Cormac Costello. The man who got 3 points in the last replay final, coming on for Niall Scully. With 12 minutes still to go, Gavin Crowley making way. And Killian Spillane is coming in at this stage. James McCarthy. It's an absolutely intriguing game. Which they can still go either way, even though there are four between them. The kick-out success there, enjoyed by both teams.
Kerry have given Dublin essentially all the kick-outs in the last round. Very hard to build momentum once you're conceding that. The tiredness is crept in, of course.
Costello back there helping with Philly McMahon. Rolled in, cutting it out was Paul Murphy. Concerned about an injury earlier on, but he's perfectly okay. Likewise, Kilkenny. Back as far as Brian Fenton. Fenton just holding it here against David Moran. It'll turn. Beautiful movement by Fenton. Can he finish with a score here? It drifts away from goal and is very much offline.
Paul Murphy has cramp. He's finished at this stage. He was actually trying to sweep there but could not fill the gap due to cramp.
They have used four of their possible six subs so far. And this is the fourth. It's Brian coming on, hoping that he will work the Oracle once again. And Paul Murphy's day this afternoon anyway is finished. Both sets of supporters now getting right behind their teams, raising the noise level to spectacular levels at Croke Park. The Dubs on Hill 16, as vociferous and supportive as ever. Kerry goes short. Back it comes as far as Tyke Morley. There's a ball to give, which he gives as far as Stephen O'Brien, who now might have an opportunity to move it on. Into the centre to Sean O'Shea. Good ball across here. Nicely done. Gavin Crowley. Held on to well by Tommy Walsh. Walsh cutting back. Laying it off here as far as Killian Spillane. Immediately two Dublin players go to him. Back out to Gavin White. Jack Barry. Still a fair distance out. That's touched back once again to Barry. Finally ready to crack one with that left boot of his, but he has missed it.
They're looking for a touch for a 45. They're not getting it.
Well, he seems convinced it did touch one of the Dublin players, but as you say, please follow the deaf ears. Former Costello, three subs Dublin have used so far. So they've got lots of reserve still. And they've got a 4-point lead, a as they try to retain the title. Taken very quickly. Oops! John Small was the one racing fairly. Getting in there was Jack Sherwood, but it bounces back to Paul Mannion, given off to Kieran Kilkenny. And a chance for Brian Howard now to set up the next attack. Sensibly in there to Conor Callaghan. Well, he goes, tight roll is after him. Show of the shoulders. Back to James McCarthy. That's not half bad. James McCarthy, wearing number 6, playing in midfield, making it 116 to 14 points after nearly 62 minutes.
Good score, and what it really tells you now is, from my perspective anyway, Kerry must get a goal. They're just drifting out of the game unless they get a big score soon.
That's a huge run in there towards Tommy Welsh, but there were three defenders back there, two of them marking him in particular. Bad ball away to Gavin Crowley. Becky comes here to Spillane. Killian Spillane. And again it is Croxton. A very good fist away, but Paul Gainey, the first one to pick it up. So much depends on Gainey, Sean O'Shea and Clifford here. And that one is over the bar. It's Sean O'Shea, his second point of the second half, both from play. They're not out of it just yet. 116 to 15 points.
He got two bites at that one. The turnover, obviously, I think with Davy Byrne, the kick is straight to Curryman, but then on the fist from Cluxton, falls nicely for Gainey, but he tidies it up lovely, gets it across to O'Shea, and he takes a swing over the bar. Just the trick, just like 4 points in it now.
Fitzsimons out here to David Byrne. Down the line here and given away. Corbett Costello didn't appreciate that. Gave him no chance whatever to retain it. No margin for error. There's an All-Ireland to be won.
It's small matter of 5 in a row to be won as well, and you have to say they're in the driving seat now. You don't want to tempt fate, but Dublin are in a great position now.
Jack Dowry ready to boot it back in. David Bolan. Oh, Clifford trying to hold possession there. Toe poked away by Fitzsimons to Brian Fenton, who has been such a dominant figure in the centre of park today. Dermot Connolly excelling and enjoying himself. And as I mentioned, if he steals, that gives that pass away. And Sean O'Shea's able to pick it up. And it's now Killian Spillane running past Davy Byrne. Spillane looking to try and get the next score for Kerry. Make it just a one-score game. Back to Clifford. Into Jack Sherwood. Moran. Wriggling away from Fenton. Kicking it a little off balance. And wide as well. Too many chances now have gone astray by Kerry in the last 10 minutes of this match.
9 points against it in the last day. An ugly number in an All-Ireland final.
James O'Donoghue is coming on in place of Jack Barry. And that is an acknowledgement that they've got to go for scores now at this stage. Plenty of players who can battle in the middle of the park. They need recognised scorers. And that is a free kick to Dublin.
Unreal. Unreal by Howard there. He had no right to win that break at all. Three Kerryman. There he is. Look at that for desire. Look at that for the requirement in the final minutes of the final.
Sheer hunger and desire. Kilkenny just holding it again, ready to run and support the man on the ball every opportunity he gets. Johnny Cooper so much happier in this particular game than he was in that nightmare match maybe 2 weeks ago for him. Brian Howard, who won that last goal to set up this next attack. So economical, so decisive. They've shown themselves to be the team of the last 5 years. Now can they finish off with another All-Ireland and be the first team in GAA history to win 5 summer bars in a row? It's advantage Dublin. Kerry can't get the ball off them. And it's Johnny Cooper. Sherwood's going across. Everybody bar Tommy Walsh back now at this stage. Kieran Kilkenny again there, just dominating possession. John Small giving it out as far as Paul Mannion. those with 4 points so far in this game. Likewise, Ciarán Kilkenny and Conn O'Callaghan. It's turned over, and it's Sherwood, and it's out to Gavin White. And Kerry are coming again, and it's David Clifford out as far as Paul Gainey. 40 metres out from the Dublin goal. Gainey into the D, getting a bit of space, making space for himself, and the pass then goes astray. And as Brian Fenton was ready to pick it up, a boot came in, a foul committed, and a free given Dublin's way.
And 50 yellow for David Clifford, pulled dangerously across the ball. But the Paul Gainey probing, you could see what was on his mind. He was looking for the gap, trying to get someone come off the shoulder, and a loose hand pass, turnover.
If that had been at the other side of the field, Kevin, you feel a Dublin player would probably have finished with a point.
Yeah. Well, of course, the requirement now from the Kerry perspective is goals, goals, goals. The clock is ticking as the soundtrack, so they know they're in trouble.
25, Kian O'Sullivan comes on. Well, he was a link with the team that won back in 2011. They're going off. Is Brian Howard, number 12, and also coming in, number 23, Kevin McManaman.
Well, McManaman on his way off as well for him.
Is that freshening up Dublin ahead by 4 points, or is it saying we've pretty much got this wrapped up?
It has the look of a lap of honour, but I wouldn't go there just yet.
Here's Kian O'Sullivan. Kilkenny now. He's covered some ground today, Ciarán Kilkenny. Nice ball ahead there by James McCarthy. Nice precise ball to Connolly. Back it comes. McManaman. He'd like to score. And Allwood. Dean Rock is going to. Two for him. Some performance. Some group of talented players representing the Blue and Navy of Dublin. And they're ahead by five.
It's certainly looking good now. Brilliant play again. McManaman, Connolly involved, picking the right moment, and over the shoulder, Rock. Not as prominent as the last day, of course, he played a major part, but tipping away with his scores all the time. Lovely, lovely pair.
Well, this has been a different kind of game. James O'Donoghue out to Gavin Crowley. They need a goal. Where's it to come from? Tommy Walsh, James O'Donoghue, former Footballer of the Year, into a whole group of Dublin players looking for space, very little available. Back it comes to Clifford, off balance. It's still up there. O'Shea. Oh, in came Cooper, but out comes Kian O'Sullivan. More importantly, he's got the ball. A couple of Kerry players down. Out they get it as far as James McCarthy, and in the end, the referee is just halting the play. Having a word here with Stephen O'Brien. Going to be a yellow card here for one Kerry man. There could be a Dublin trouble as well, possibly Cormac Costello. So a yellow card for Stephen O'Brien. And I think the referee is also looking out for Cormac Costello following that last little bit of play. That was
the O'Brien one, wasn't it? Yeah. And he is looking for Cormac Costello. Can't find him at the moment. Played hide and go seek, I think. But this all suits Dublin perfectly, even though the time will be added on. But this is just running down the clock now. The advantage at five in the hill are in full song.
Great time to be a Dublin fan. Such a wonderfully successful team they've had over the years. This is the Costello card now I anticipated coming up. Worth having a look at what happened there. Yeah, just have a look at this one more time, Kevin.
It's where Clifford goes to ground.
Was there a penalty there, do you think?
I can see now. Here's just there.
Was it Kilkenny who came in on top of him?
Yeah. Okay, he could have given it.
None given. Two possible penalties in this match. 5 minutes of additional time are going to be played. Conn O'Callaghan scampers away here. Up as far as McManaman. McManaman kicking, and as usual, he misses. I was about to say he scored, but he's missed. That has tormented Kerry teams over the years, as we know well. Darragh Moynihan is the next one who's going to come in, be the last sub introduced. And there is Darragh Moynihan from Spa. So confirmation then on the 5 minutes of added time, but right now there's only a 3.5 left. They always say at least, and it's Dublin who are enjoying themselves down there right now, and it's Dermot Connolly. Connolly with two out of sight again. Oh, what a stop by Ryan! And then in the end he makes another stop from Conor Callaghan. Really good goalkeeping by Shane Ryan. What about this for a double save?
The boys either side of him won't thank him, and the Hill would have loved it, of course, but at the end of the day it's a brilliant save by Shane Ryan.
Well, he's had some very good moments in these two matches, and he's done himself an awful lot of good, because when we're looking ahead to these two finals, a lot of people were saying, well, this man has very little experience and Dublin will throw everything they've got at him because of that lack of experience. There it is, the Sam Maguire Cup. It's heading for Dublin for the fifth year in a row. Another couple of minutes to go. A 45 for Dublin and for Dean Rock. They haven't scored anything from frees so far. They haven't had to. It's the first time they've got a dead ball situation here, and it's Dean Rock with his team five up. No real pressure this time. Catches it beautifully and it floats over. 6 points the margin, five in a row, that man is thinking. Another change made, and it's Michael Darragh McCauley who gets on for the final moments, and he deserves to do so because he's been an integral part of Dublin teams over all of the last 5 years. Whatsoever now that Kerry can do about this. They gave it their best shot. They were 10 points apiece at half time. That goal at the start of the second half set the tone for things, and then there was a gap of 4 and 5 points. Kerry missed too many scoring opportunities. Nine wides tells its own tale. Brian Howard, the one going off to enable Michael Darragh to come on. He has been one of their great stars, a fine young emerging footballer, Mike Brian Howard. And they greet that substitution very warmly for both players, the man coming on and the man going off.
They've been terrific.
David Moran. Well, an extra minute, I think, would probably be added on because of all these changes now within the 5 minutes. Tommy Walsh kicking it across, 3 against 1. David Clifford keeping it alive. Sean O'Shea, and eventually it was Stephen O'Brien who was coming in, and that ball has gone out there, claiming it should have been a 45. They're not going to get it. The umpire's made the call. You've got Kieran Kilkenny, I think, down there. Or is it Johnny Clifford? Johnny Cooper, in fact, the one who's down with a cramp. But this is what happened.
Having a chat about it, but I think it seems to have got the call right. It looked to me that he just pulled it on the fly.
Well, what a moment this is for Jim Gavin. He has never lost a championship match against Kerry. He has a 90% success rate with Dublin in championship football. They appreciate what he has done. We remember that they lost badly in 2009, 10 years ago, to Kerry. Who could have foreseen at that stage that this would be the decade of the Dubs? Last 30 seconds or thereabouts. It's Kieran Kilkenny who holds on to it. I think he was expecting a final whistle. Let the referee do that, Kieran. Now it comes to Costello. Cormac Costello from Whitehall, Columbkills, just up the road from here. John Small.
Well, Callan is out.
Here's Brian Fenton. Brian Fenton will be so delighted to have got this chance to come back and redeem himself in many respects he's been one of the very, very fine performance Dublin have had this afternoon. Matt Menaman missed a throwing chance a little while ago. Back in towards Connolly. Might have been in America, that's an aggressive foul, so it's going to be free kick for Kerry later on. He charged into the nearest Kerry defender. Out it comes, and James O'Donoghue once again holding possession. David Moran, the final whistle, it's all over! Jim Gavin, Jason Sherlock embrace. Dublin are the history makers. It's taken them two games, but they're All-Ireland champions for the fifth year in a row. Truly, Gaelic football's invincibles. And there's the goal scorer just after half-time. A matter of seconds after the throw-in, Owen Merchant raided and booted it into the back of the Kerry net. Peter Keane and Jim Gavin there just having words. What a remarkable evening for Dublin and for the GAA. There's Jack McCaffrey. And the man who got on towards the end, Michael Durham-McCauley. Well, Kerry gave it their very best. They took Dublin to a replay, but they still failed to dislodge the champions. So many others have tried to do so, but Stephen Cluxton will once again come up the steps of the Hogan Stand, and he will proudly lift the Sam Maguire Cup. And they deserve their victory, Kevin.
Yeah, for sure. The marching goal just after halftime changed the momentum of everything. The Cluxton save, maybe I'll got the three-quarter stage chair. Another huge moment in the game. But this is the history-making team in the history of the GAA. Probably the greatest team of all time, certainly in my lifetime. What a group of players, and all so brilliantly led by the great Jim Gavin. You know, with an old military line, if you command wisely, you will be obeyed cheerfully. And he has done a terrific, terrific job trying to keep everything ticking over 5 years, Ger. That's not a short spell of time, and he has done it terrifically. But his team have been a credit. They played the game the way it's supposed to be played. High tempo, high skill, great footballers. Three or four of these lads will enter the pantheon of great players, I've no doubt. What a night for them.
Let's the full-time score here at the end of it all. It's Dublin, one goal and 18 points. Kerry, 15 points. Let's go down to Claire McNamara.
Gerard, with Ciarán Kilkenny. Ciarán, congratulations. This really is an extraordinary moment in Irish sporting history.
Yeah, that's the most special feeling I've ever felt in my whole life. I'm so emotional. Such relief after the first game, such a titanic battle, with such respect for this Kerry team, and to just get over the line means so much to this group. Grown men out there in tears, we're so proud of each other, our families, this county. What can I say, I'm absolutely delighted.
Five in a row, it's been done, you're the ones to do it, how can you take it all in?
We can just, I suppose we can just go and party!
What a performance from Ciarán Kilkenny, as predicted, it must be said, by Ciarán Whelan before the match even started. But Ciarán, as the dub in the room. Three teams before had come close to making it five in a row, but this is the team that finally did it.
A special day, Joanne, a piece of history. You know, you go back to the forefathers of Dublin football, Heffernan from the 50s, you know, Nicky Whelan from the 60s, what he's contributed to this team at the start, starting this in 2011. Blue Panther Antonio Tua from the 70s, Mullins, Keaveney, they set the foundations, I think, for, you know, these guys that they looked up to, you know, that they wanted to follow. We went through the dark days, we had the dark days, but then a special group of players came along, combined with brilliant, I suppose, legends like Stephen Cluxton, who transformed the game, you know, the Kilkennys, the O'Callaghans, the Fentons, you know, and you that was guys that were hurting after the last day. Brilliant, brilliant game. You know, they've created a brilliant piece of history. I'm not going to compare them, saying they're the best team of all time, but I wasn't around when Pat played, so, and I don't think that's a fair thing to do. But I think, listen, they're a special, special group, and they deserve this moment.
Well, Ciarán Kilkenny mentioned grown men crying. We may have one close to it in the studio as well. That's Kieran, not you, Pat's plan.
I'm crying as well. No, I mean, look, can I just applaud this Dublin team? We are seeing one of the, like, their achievements is absolutely magnificent. They're the most successful team of the modern generation. You look through the statistics, 5-0, 7 titles this decade, 36 championship matches unbeaten, 6 years Jim Gavin has been manager, 1 championship defeat. Do you know, they're a truly great team, great players, great role models, and they play football the way it's supposed to be played. They're just a credit. What I like about them, brilliant manager Jim Gavin, but they're all leaders. They're all leaders. Their decision making, their game management, their composure, their unselfishness, they're a team. And hats off to them tonight. They deserve every accolade, every praise. This was a well-deserved, no excuses, no nothing at all. The best team by a mile won on the day.
We do know, Stephen Rochford, that they do breeze through Leinster. Sometimes people then think that that's the way it is in the All-Ireland series. But as you know personally, they're made fall all the way as they were today to claim Sam Maguire.
Well, they're totally deserving of every accolade, every description of them. They've earned it. Year in, year out, they set the standards. You know, and in fairness, going back to foundations, you know, people like Pat Gilroy, Mickey Whelan, you know, they really shook the tree, and certainly Jim Gavin, Declan Darty, you know, Shane O'Hanlon, Jason Sherlock, you know, Mick Deegan and Paul Clark, all those guys have really built on it, and they deserve everything that they get now.
There's one word to land that sums them up over the last 5 years, I suppose, is resilience. I'm dealing with adversity. When teams, as Stephen touched on, when other teams threw everything at them, they always found a way. They're always able to manage the game, you know, and any time they came up against an obstacle, they're able to deal with it. Yes, they got breaks along the way, they got a bit of luck along the way, but, you know, I think that was overall
great teams, just winning teams make their own look. And that's it. No matter what tactics have been thrown against them, no matter what game plans they've come up against, no matter what opposition, they study the opposition, they don't panic, they tease away around it, and they'll always, it's their composure, their decision making, their game management is so superb.
And they play the game in whatever way that's needed. I mean, they've got, you know, from the back, and Stephen Cluxton, they've got a guy that has changed the way that they look at the game from that far back in the field. Today we saw masterclass from many defenders in the Mick Fitzsimons, I give, and Owen Merchant, I give particular praise. John Small actually as well, the job, you know, Sean O'Shea, and then up the field, I mean, you know, we got 3 guys today with 4 points each from play. You know, they can just do it in whatever shape or form that they want.
But a true sign of a great team is never dependent on any one or two players. You can have 5 star players today and 5 fellas subdued the last day, and suddenly it's role reversing. The likes of Conor Callan, the likes of Kieran Kilkenny, quite games by their own standards today, absolutely superb and magical. And they can do that because they have so many leaders and they have so many great players, and they're not dependent on one. They're truly a team.
And you, of course, know, Pat, how difficult it is, no matter how great you were considered, to come up against the pressures of trying to make history as Dublin did today.
Look, I know what it's like to lose a 5-0. You know, it's hot, it's desperate. I sat in the dressing room and locked myself into a toilet cubicle and I cried for 5 minutes. But you know, by Tuesday, we resolved to get over it. And this, it's only a game, and we move on again. Now, it's hard for Kerry, you know. There's only, like Babs Keaton said, you know, it's only between a pat in the back and a kick, and there's only a short little distance. Today is Dublin's day, they deserve all the accolades. Kerry went down fighting, they're a young team. Hopefully they will be back, but they've done Kerry and Peter Keane proud this year.
I think that's hugely important. You know, Kerry came up the last day and nobody gave them a chance. They were written off by everybody, and everybody expected Dublin to coast to victory. They were super the last day, and it was very, very difficult for a young team. We spoke about before it again, the psychology of being a defender, and Dublin, the Kilkennys, the O'Callaghans, the Mannions, they wouldn't have been happy with their performance, and it's so different. Those key matchups went against them early on, and once those lads get on a bus, the talent they have is just on a different level.
There was a near eerie silence there for a little while. The Dublin fans are sensing that they're finally going to get to see Sam Rae's once again. It'll be for the 6th time by their captain and their goalkeeper, Stephen Cluxton. Ger.
Let's hear from the oath they're on coming to Craswell, Sean O'Horoy.
The hug and shade done come out to show. Covron Kiri, big loyal with. Today, a new chapter in the history of our wonderful organisation has been written. Cogardigas Ahatlea, August Curran Che Ahas Moorum, Curran San Maguire Abruna, Captain Ahatlea, Don Kulgu Warden Ega Kayla, to Stephen Cluxton.
I'm just delighted to be accepting this cup on behalf of the Dublin senior football team. This All-Ireland obviously means so, so much to this Dublin team. The sacrifices that we've gone through, the hard yards that we've put in. But on behalf of the team, I suppose, I'd just like to thank the officers of Crow Park for organising the competition. Thank you. To Kerry, a fantastic two games to be playing in. It was nip and tuck for both games. It could have gone either way. I know you guys will be back ready for it again next year, and hopefully we will too. So well done. I'd like to thank all our sponsors, AIG in particular, and to our other partners whose support we value. To the officers of the County Board and the staff in Parnell Park, thank you for your support for the team and for your tireless work to promote Gaelic games in Dublin. Thank you. To our management team, our backroom team, everybody there, Jim included, many thanks for your leadership, your guidance throughout the year. Thanks very much. To our families, I would like to thank you for your unrelenting support, encouragement and loyalty throughout the year. And finally, to our fantastic supporters, day in, day out, you come, you support us, you give us the backing throughout the year. It doesn't matter what it is, you're there. And we just want to say, your loyalty and support is greatly appreciated. Have a great night. Ramada.
Emotional Stephen Cluxton. You wonder, is that because of the weight of history of five in a row? Is it because he feels this may be his last? That's speculation, maybe for later. But I wonder, Kieran Whelan, did you ever wonder, would you see the same Dublin captain in your lifetime lift somewhere six times?
I remember dropping him off in training when he was only a kid. He had that raw talent. His fifth All-Ireland in a row as a captain, his seventh in total. He's transformed the game over the last, 15, 16 years he's played. He was there in the dark days. I think he learned from that, Joanne. He learned from what it was like in the dark days, and he brought forward that experience and probably was instrumental in setting the culture within that squad. A brilliant leader of men, and, he deserves, for one, he's 37 years of age, and if you look at his performance this year, you'd fear that he's going to retire because he looks as good. And he looks sharp, as he always did. His kick-outs today were just excellent.
And what an achievement. 10 of all Dublin players today are just after picking up their 7th All-Ireland medal. And you know what? Normally, when fellas like that are picking up 7 All-Ireland medals, they're just about hanging in them. This crowd aren't even remotely close to coming near retirement or anything like that.
Some of them are, Pat. There's a lot of them.
There is going to be a bunch of retirement
plan. The point I'm trying to say is that 5 in a row, it could be 6 in a row, it could be 7 in a row, it could be 8 in a row. These can achieve the impossible.